What's up, folks? Now, you guys have all heard that good things come in small packages. Now, I have a small package right here. It's the E2KM11 Deluxe. That's right, I couldn't memorize all these numbers off the bat. Now, this thing's supposed to feature the latest AMD technology. It's basically based for a thin client type user. It's gonna be very low power, very high efficiency, very quiet, and very cool. You guys can see that JJ has the Kingston Lovo memory on here. Mm-hmm. Fits this perfectly. And now we'll let JJ just tell you guys some of the real specifics that make this thing a quality component.
Yeah, so this is an awesome new board for the users that are really interested in a kind of a small form factor, everyday box. You know, they want to be able to go on YouTube, get some great quality web decoding performance, but like you said, be energy efficient, but then also maybe you'll switch over into some casual gaming, be able to load up, you know, Steam, play different games, whether it's stuff like Awesome Knots, you know, Burnout, you know, Battlefield Heroes, and be able to get some really gameplay, great gameplay performance in terms of FPS. So this is using the new AMD Trinity Core, so 1.75 gigahertz in terms of the core clock speed, but you got a Radeon 7340 GPU built inside of this, so you can actually have some really nice overall casual gaming performance.
Right, when you say casual gaming, I want to explain this to people. When we say casual gaming, we mean basically non-first-person shooter games. First-person shooter games are always the most highest. They suck up energy like no tomorrow, and they acquire lots of stuff. With the video card that's on here, you can play anything. You can play RPG games, role-playing games. Any of those type of games will actually play just fine on
that.
But you're not just strictly the Zynga games, trust me.
Yeah, no, 100%. But even in terms of FPS, depending on the engine, there can be a lot of flexibility, you know? I mean, if you're somebody that's still interested in Unreal Tournament, Counter-Strike, even
oh, yeah,
like
older games,
Go,
for sure. Oh,
we
yeah.
can definitely play all kinds of content. So it's really nice to actually have an updated graphics processor built in here. We've also done some cool updates in terms of the Wi-Fi. So we have this updated from single band to dual band, so now 2.4 and 5 gigahertz plus Bluetooth 4.0.
And
so
that you can actually comes with, I don't know if I can pull these out here, but that actually comes with one, these folks. These are the wireless. They actually work very well, and they have great distance on them. My house is very large. You know how big my house is,
yep.
JJ. When you go to the very back of my house, you hook one of these up, you actually get still really good reception.
Yeah.
And you don't have other products here, but you gave me some products of yours that actually multiply the signal.
Yeah.
Those things worked really well in the house.
Yeah, well, you'll actually be seeing some newer stuff that we're going to be showing off in our networking side. But overall, you know, you got awesome media features. We have our Wi-Fi to go, which allows you to do DLNA media serving to different devices like tablets or televisions or different types of devices. Of course, you've got USB 3 integrated in here with our USB 3 boost, and even our network eye control, which allows you to do packet priority so you can get better video decoding performance or better application network performance as well. So overall, a really rich board.
The size of my hand.
Yeah, that's the size of your hand, and super cool, super quiet. The fan can entirely be controlled. So for you guys, this thing operates in terms of whisper quiet, but if you want to be able to tweak and tune it, you can go into our great software, whether it's in the UEFI or whether it's in Windows, they would be able to adjust it. So a really nice small form factor board, people looking for HTPC, everyday box, or a small form factor little gaming box.
Do you know what the manufacturer sector retail price on this one is yet?
We haven't said it, but it's going to be coming to market soon, and generally these boards are priced pretty competitively. Usually you're going to be looking somewhere about $180 to about $220, considering that's already got the CPU.
Well, yeah, you just throw memory on it and you're gone.
And
yeah.
You're good to go. So priced pretty competitively, but final pricing, like I said, you know, make sure to just check out to your favorite retailer, and I'm sure it's going to be available there.
Yeah, and one thing that's really cool about this, you guys are going to see in the future, I've heard that a lot of companies are going to start developing more cases for these. So right now, cases are limited. You pretty much stick it in a little tiny square thing, that's what it is. But in the future, next year, which well, I guess is upon us now, you're gonna see all kinds of new cases that actually will accommodate these, so you get a choice, which will be cool. So all right, folks, see you guys back here on Tech of Tomorrow. JJ, take care, brother, and we'll see you for another video
soon. Thanks for stopping by, guys.